How to install the Google Chrome browser on Android TV devices like the Nvidia Shield TV, the Xiaomi TV Box, the Sony TVs, the Philips TVs and so on, and of course on any Fire TV device like the Fire Stick, the Fire TV Cube, and also have the latest updated version always. Make sure to subscribe on Tech is My Passion and enable the notifications in order to get always the latest videos. Hello beautiful people and welcome to Tech is My Passion. I am Dimi and I suspect Tech is your passion too, since you are on this amazing channel, which by the way, make sure to subscribe and enable the notifications in order to get always the latest videos. In today's video we are gonna install the latest version of Google Chrome browser and we will have it always updated, so security patches and all the latest gimmicks will work on the Google browser, of course on an Android TV device. That means though that you will need to use something different than this, than the included remote control. You can use a mouse like this one and a keyboard, and of course you can also use a keyboard and air mouse like this one, which I found also very beautiful to use, very easy to use, or like this one. I will leave a link down below in the description for both of them, since they are both air mouses. This one has a touchpad and the full keyboard. This one can be used as a normal remote. It can also used by an air remote. That means that you can point and shoot on your screen, easy as that. And when you change the layout on the back, you have a full keyboard with a touchpad, which is simply amazing. I'm gonna do also a dedicated review on this one, since it's a newish product. In any case, let's go jump into it, how we can install Chrome the browser. Of course, if you want to use a browser only with a remote control, my recommendation is TV Bro, TV browser. I will leave also for that a link down below in the description and also on the upper right corner. In any case, let's move into my Nvidia Shield TV. But as I've mentioned, it works on any device. Now, in order to install it, first of all, we are gonna need to download Downloader. If you do not have it already, let's install it together. Simply select the Google Play Store for Android TV, that is, of course. And now go and search for Downloader. We're gonna search Downloader. Here it is, the first result. Downloader by AFTV News, back with the original developer. So select it and then hit install. By the way guys, please select the thumbs up down below in this video so you can help me also with this YouTube algorithm. Thank you very much. Once we have downloaded it, let's open it, and the first time it will ask you this thing over here, allow, give a permission in order to have access on your local drive. Of course you need to do that. Quick start guide, okay. Now on the Fire TV device you can simply select the browser from the left column and you will be ready to go, but as you can see on the Android TV devices, it gives you this message. To use the built-in browser, you must install sideload the Downloader browser plugin. That means, easy peasy, very easy, we are gonna go onto home and inside this box, we are gonna enter browser. Now I could have been using the keyboard, honestly, but in any case, browser dot, I'm gonna do it like that, AFTV News, AFTVnews.com. I love this remote control. By the way, this is the Shield 2015 and it still rocks. I have posted also a post on my Instagram and a lot of you guys appreciated it. Now, backspace, back button. Not backspace, it's just a button since it's a remote, and then select go. It will ask you, okay, let's let it download. Okay, it will ask you to give permissions in order to install also unknown sources applications from unknown sources, also for the Downloader application. So we're gonna select settings, We're gonna search for downloader, which is just behind me. It's disabled. Simply make it blue by clicking on it. Go back and select once again install. Once again, I have to move my beautiful face. Okay. Here we are. Now we need to select install. Here we go. And we have installed the browser plugin. Now we're going to delete this file since we do not need it. Okay, we have installed it. And now from the left column, we can select browser. We have a browser, sort of, but it's very basic. Okay, I'm going to consent the first time, usual stuff. Now, inside the URL bar, we are going to enter Dimitrology, which is an amazing guy, by the way, and a fantastic website. Highly recommended. Make sure to go visit it either way. Bookmark it, whatever you want. Dimitrology.com, my website. Okay, and we're gonna select go. Now, inside here, we can select the hamburger menu. And we are gonna select Android APK. If it's not working, as it isn't in here in this example, we are gonna go all the way down. And here it is. Download Android APK. This beautiful image I have created in Photoshop. So we are gonna go and select, where is it? Here. The main category is Applications, Markets, Download APK. And although I said we're gonna install Chrome, we're gonna do it through an app store, the Aurora or Aurora store. Let me select it. Oh, we have also an ad. And this app will give you not only the latest version of Aurora. Let me select download now first. Okay, here it is. We're gonna select it. Small file in size. Not only it will give you the latest version of Chrome browser, it will also update it every now and then. And the best part with it, let's hit install as soon as it finishes. We have already given permission before, if you remember. Okay, done. And delete the downloaded file. All righty. As I've said, with Aurora Store, you can also update the latest version every single time there is an update. And the best part with it is that it only accesses files from the official Android store by Google themselves. And I'm gonna show you exactly what I mean. Now we have though to select the app, so let's go and find it. Here it is, no, where it is, the last one, Aurora Store. Let's launch it. And here, even though we can also use the remote some occasions, let me try to use it all the way if I can. Okay, we need to give the permissions, allow. Opt for a login as anonymous. That's the best way in my opinion. Now, once we are inside the store, as you can see, we have all the applications that you can find also in the Google Play Store. But what is amazing with this application is that you can spoof your device. You can, let's say, masquerade your device. You are gonna fool Google Play Store thinking that this is not an Nvidia Shield or an Android TV device in general. Instead, it will be a phone. So, how we can do that? Select the column on the upper left corner and select where it says spoof. Now we're gonna select the first option, spoof device. I'm gonna use the mouse so you can guys see exactly where I'm selecting. Okay, here we are, spoof device. And from this list, I'm gonna select the Pixel, or better yet, the Pixel 2 device, which is, I think, at the end, almost at the end. Here it is. And you will get this message. The setting will be applied when you log in inside the app again. So we are gonna go back once again, and always from this screen, simply select where it says accounts, and now select to log out. Awesome. Now we're gonna log in once again with a different device, the Pixel 2. And if we are gonna go back, here it is, If I'm gonna search for the Google Chrome browser, as you can see, it already finds Chrome as a result. Meanwhile, when we were in the Android TV version of Google Play Store, we could only find these two results, Chromecast and Chromecast built-in. Now I'm gonna select Chrome. Awesome. Here it is, Chrome Fast and Secure. Select it once again and now hit Install. It should start downloading the latest version. As you can see, as of right now, November 11th, 2020, 86.0.yadayada.yadayada. Let's let it finish. Okay. You have to give permission, of course, also on Aurora. So let me show you guys what I didn't show you earlier. Simply select Aurora and make this button over here blue. That means that also Aurora or Aurora can install applications. Let's go back. Yep. Okay. Now I'm going to select once again install. Awesome. Let's let it finish just to show you guys that it works and it works great. So you can have the full experience of a Chrome browser also on your Android TV device. Let's select install. I don't know if I will get a message or not. But anywho, it should be installing right now. You can also opt for the beta version of Chrome, which I don't recommend, honestly. Better have the latest and stable version of Android. And also I wanted to show you guys that if you are gonna search for anything on the Google Play Store, as I've mentioned, these are the official sources from the Google Play Store servers. You do not have to be worried about malwares and stuff like that. You can also search for any application on the store. So if I'm gonna search, I don't know, Netflix, I should get the Netflix version of a smartphone, which of course I will not install because I have the Android version. But as you can see also the photos, this is the smartphone version. Of course, it is meant for you to download applications that do not have versions of Android TV, which is highly recommended. And also, last thing I wanted to show you is if you go into updates, you can see the updates that are available. You can install them from here or you can simply install them from the Google Play Store on your home screen. Now, if I'm gonna go back, I need to launch, of course, also Chrome. I will not find it inside here. I have done plenty of videos on how you can find those applications. Oh, no, it can find it, which is strange. Awesome. Oh, we have also Chrome, the icon. Awesome. But as I've mentioned, you need always to use an Air mouse or mouse and a keyboard. I will help and continue. Okay, yes, I'm in. Sync your passwords. Awesome. Boom shakalaka, baby. As you can see, we are inside the full version of Android Store and of Google Chrome browser. Where is my head? And let's do for dimitrology.com. Boom shakalaka, baby, as you can see, fully working. Everything works perfectly. We got also Google Chrome installed on our Android TV device. That's all, guys. I hope you enjoyed also today's video. Highly requested video, even though I prefer using the old-fashioned remote for Android TV OS. If you enjoyed this video, hit the thumbs up. If you didn't, dislike the video, but make sure to subscribe on this amazing channel, offering you always the best. Follow me on all the social media platforms. I'm at Dimitrology. Dimi Tech is my passion. At Facebook, on Instagram, on Twitter, on Reddit, all over the place. Very social guy. Visit my website, dimitrology.com, for more apps like this. And of course, for a lot of tutorials, streaming news and stuff like that. Tech in general. And we will catch up, as always, on the upcoming video. Thank you for watching.